Hello, and welcome to our study of the ABCs of a Godly Heart by Cassandra Martin. Today we are on the letter W, and we're going to be looking at our response to God being worthy, which is to worship Him. Worship is a verb. It means to express adoration, reverence, and honor. Our key verse is 1 Chronicles 16, verse 29, which says, "Ascribe to the Lord the glory due His name. Bring an offering and come before Him. Worship the Lord in the splendor of His holiness." Worship is an invitation to enter into His presence and to be changed. When you worship, you should walk away a new person. It's an opportunity to open our hearts in praise, to allow adoration to pour from our lips, and to let thanksgiving open our eyes to His presence, to offer ourselves in full surrender to the glory of the Lord. Worship is our response to the recognition that we have that God is worthy. Worship gives us an avenue to celebrate His provision, to honor His power, and to be touched by His presence. Today, we're going to look at three different ways how worship changes us and the truths about this change. The first one is that worship makes our eyes bigger. The truth of this is that worship is about interaction. In worship, we meet God. It is about us deliberately choosing to enter the presence of God and to be together with Him. Our eyes are open to all that He is and all that He does by interacting with Him. In worship, God actively moves among us. He fills us with His presence, washes us clean with His grace, surrounds us with His love, and moves us with His transforming power. He delights to meet us in worship. He meets us in worship as we take the Lord's Supper, as we sing, pray, give, and as we listen to His word.
In Mark 6, we see the account of Jesus walking out on the water to His disciples. If we're picking up in verse 51, it says, "Then He climbed into the boat with them, and the wind died down. They were completely amazed, for they had not understood about the loaves. Their hearts were hardened." So did you catch that last part? Their hearts were hardened during the feeding of the 5,000, which had just occurred before this. It happens to us too, right? When we don't quite understand something, or if we're going through a hard time, the disciples didn't quite understand how amazing Jesus really was. Well, worship makes our hearts softer too. Just like the disciples were amazed at Jesus walking on the water, amazement should also define our moments of worship. When we recognize who God is, when we truly see Him, before the disciples experienced this moment in the boat, their hearts were hard. And this particular moment profoundly change them. So worship is also about transformation, interaction, and transformation. Meeting God in worship opens the doors to transformation. Every time we come before Him, He moves to change us, shape us, cleanse us, and mold us into the image of His Son. In Romans 12:2, Paul urges us to put away this world and be transformed by the renewing of our minds. Then we will be able to see what God's will is. We also see how meeting God in worship should change us in 2 Corinthians 3:18, which says, "And we all who with unveiled faces contemplate the Lord's glory are being transformed into His image with ever-increasing glory, which comes from the Lord who is the Spirit." The last point on worship is that it makes our lives fuller. In John 6, we see the same account in Mark of Jesus walking out on the water, but we also see the disciples in this account willingly take Jesus into the boat. The word willing. See, the disciples, They wanted to be near Jesus. They were amazed. They understood. Their hearts were no longer hardened. They were willing to make room for him in that boat. Worship is about interaction, transformation, and surrender. It reminds us to empty ourselves of self and make room for God. Worship calls us to a deeper experience with God as we surrender and put down the barriers or whatever it is that's hindering us from being in God's presence. And don't we all want our lives to become full of his presence? Revelation 3:20 tells us that when he knocks on our door and we answer, well, he's going to come in and sit with us and eat with us. We're going to be with him. So let's worship. Today was my first day back at worship in the congregation, and it truly was amazing. I was brought to teary eyes a few times just listening to everyone singing and feeling that nearness that sometimes only worshiping with our brothers and sisters in Christ can bring.
Today we're going to look at Psalm 100. So let's turn there and read it together. Psalm 100. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are the people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Enter his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Psalm 100 is a call to worship and to be joyful as we are in worship. As we worship, it is a grateful expression of our souls. Worship is a matter of the heart. This psalm calls us to an activated, conscientious mindset that you choose to worship. Worship is not just showing up and checking it off your box. Worship is a matter of the heart and being changed through your interaction and transformation with God. Worship is God-centered. It is not man-centered. Now, that's the thing that a lot of people kind of mess up about worship, is they start thinking it's all about them. It's what they're getting out of it. But really, it's what you are giving to God because of who he is and what he's done for you. Worship is all about glorifying God because he is worthy. Worship directs our eyes to the house of God. It invites us to go in with open eyes and full hearts to be filled with thanksgiving and praise and joy. In worship, we enter God's presence and we bring him the sacrifice of praise. Songs and thanksgiving pour from our lips as we make the journey into his presence. There's a time for stillness, and that's when we catch our breath and wonder at the way he loves us and how he always cares for us. There's a moment of awe when we get a glimpse of his glory and we begin to understand that he is worthy. Worship draws our hearts close to him and we are changed. It is not a one-time event. Worship is a continual offering that each servant of his chooses to make. In worship, we receive from God's gracious hand, and your response is your kindness in gratitude and in praise. Please join us next week. We're in the tail stretch of our study. We have three more letters. Next week, we'll be tackling X, which is the Greek word for Christos, and the letter Y, which is yearns. We look forward to seeing you then.